Hello and welcome to Pakati TV. I'm your host, Khaya and Ndubane. With me is Sibongiseni Gumbi and Thembinkosi Sekgphane. This week we change our focus to the Absa Premiership, with the main focus being on the game between Orlando Pirates and AmaZulu, which is going to take place at Orlando Stadium on Saturday night. AmaZulu have not beaten Orlando Pirates since 2013, with Pirates winning the last game 3-1 in the Telkom knockout. Having said that, AmaZulu have just beaten Mamelodi Sundowns and Cape Town City, who are title contenders. Can we see another upset at Orlando Stadium on Saturday night, Mr. Gumbi?
You know, they say you never beat a man when he's down, but this is the only chance AmaZulu have of ever beating Pirates if they were to end this dominance, because things have not been going well for Pirates in the last three games. Teams seem to have figured them out. They easily just put one midfielder in there to just frustrate their three overloaded midfield, and then it's all over for Pirates. So I see AmaZulu doing the same with Vilakazi there, just dominating that midfield and spraying those passes to the likes of Ntuli to break into that defense. And AmaZulu have these big bullish strikers who will bully the likes of Jele and Alfred Ndengane, and they'll match them for height and for best. So it's going to be an interesting match. But I see AmaZulu getting that goal and winning, and then sealing the 3 points away from Orlando on Saturday afternoon.
You've heard what Mr. Gumbi said, TK. Can we perhaps see another dominance from Paris, having not lost to AmaZulu since 2013?
Well, I mean, Khaya, the record speaks for Pirates playing against the AmaZulu. But again, I think Pirates has been playing well when you consider the last match. It's just that, you know, playing well doesn't always mean that you win games by scoring goals. So they just need to score first. And I feel like, you know, they've been playing well, but they just need to turn the corner. And I feel the game against AmaZulu is the point where that will be the turning point for the team, for them to obviously be in contention for the league as well. So that's another reason that they would want to, that would make them want to win the game. And they're playing at home, so they have the home ground advantage. So I think they will win against AmaZulu.
You heard what our resident expert have to say about the game between Pirates and AmaZulu. But that's not the only game this coming weekend. Starting tonight, there is a game between Chippa United and Golden Arrows down in PE. There's also on Saturday, Polokwane City take on Kaizer Chiefs. Cape Town City take on Maritzburg United, and then Bidvest in a, which is another big game of the weekend, between the top of the table clash between Bidvest and Mamelodi Sundowns. We've alluded to the Pirates, AmaZulu, and then Super Sport takes on Baroka. On Sunday, Black Leopards will host Highlands Park at Tohoyandou Stadium. And then there is a Free State derby between Bloemfontein Celtic and Free State Stars. Talking about the Free State derby, your thoughts on the Free State derby, Mr. Gumbi?
It will be a good game, but I just see a walkover for Bloemfontein Celtic. I mean, Free State Stars, things are not going well for them. So I just see it as a game that an easy 3 points for Celtic, who are also having their own problems. But on the field, they don't seem to have problems, although they have bottom problems. So it's an easy pickings for them.
TK, your thoughts on the Free State derby?
Khaya, I have to agree with Sibongiseni on this one. I think Bloemfontein Celtic will win the game against Free State Stars, because you know, you look at the troubles that Free State Stars have been going through, with the changing of coaches, with losing some players, and also the players that have come in the January transfer window to try and help the team. They have not made a difference. And so I think Bloemfontein Celtic will win the game. And when you look at some of the players in Celtic, I mean, when you speak to them, they are confident, even though there are troubles, you know, with the financial problems with the team, but they're very focused on what they want to do. They want to play for the team, and they want to play for the interim coach as well. So I think they'll win the derby.
You heard what our experts have to say about this weekend's action. You can also have your say on our social media pages. On Twitter is at Pagati, on Facebook is Pagati. Until next week, enjoy the beautiful game.